Brahma Gana Sabha Talevar Sri Nadir Kupiswami Chetty Avargale, Brahma Gana Sabha Chairalar Sri Ravichandran Avargale, Sabha Chairalar Sri N Balasubramanian Avargale, Brahma Gana Sabha Purulalar Sri K Mahalingam Avargale, Indru Viratu Valankiyavar Dr. K. J. Jasdasu Avargale, Indru Virtu Valankiyavar Srimati Madhavika Sarukai Avargale, Indru Virtu Valankiyavar Sri S. Varadarajan Avargale, Indru Velati Valankiyavar Srimati Padmavati Amma Avargale, Sri V. Srinivasan Avargale, Indrai Nigalchikki Vandirikkum Anaitu Tamila Valangukkum Vanakkam. Tamilam, Tamil Nadum, and Manadirukku, Nirukkamanavai. Brahma Gana Sabha, Kalai, Vilavil, Pankaravum, Pukalapa, Kalai, Indralakuna, Virutu Kalai, Valankavum, Nan Peru Magilchi, Adegirin. I really feel very happy today to be amidst you people and particularly amidst this great people who are doing a great service to the cause of music and which in turn brings happiness to the people. When Sri Guru Murthyji told me, I was preoccupied with other programs, but I have such a great respect to my friend Sri Guru Murthy, I can never say no to him. If it was a political advice, that would have been a different matter. Now I am not in politics and he is not going to give political advice also. I am retired from politics but not tired from public life. Yandaro Mahanubhavalu Andariki Vandanamulu. Vanakkam Namaste. I am delighted to be present in this august gathering of extraordinary musicians and music lovers of Indian classical music and inaugurate the Golden Jubilee celebrations of Brahma Gana Sabha. Founded in 1969, as said earlier, I am aware that the Brahma Gana Sabha has grown into a huge brand in the last 50 years. Its annual music festivals are well known. Events such as these have put Chennai on the world cultural map and gave the city a place in UNESCO's Creative Cities Network for contribution to music. Chennai is the third Indian city on the list of UNESCO's Creative Cities list after Varanasi was recognized as City of Music, Jaipur City of Crafts and Folk Art. I am extremely happy that this organization preserves and promotes ancient Indian music, culture and dance and traditions. I must also express my appreciation to Sabha for nurturing and encouraging talent in classical dance, music and theatre in Chennai all year round. I would also convey my best wishes to the four eminent artists felicitated during this Golden Jubilee of the Sabha. Gana Padman to Dr. K.J. Yesudasan, the great son of this great country. Natya Padman to Mrs. Madhavika Sarukai. Nataka Padman to S. Varadarajan. Earlier, Vikas Srinivasan was telling that he provides decent humor. What is missing now in humor is that decency. So I am happy if Varadarajan is providing that decency. Now, it's very good. That's what is required. The humor used to be decent. But the recent humor do not have decent humor. That's a problem. That is a problem. We must go back to our ancient times where the humor, glamour and grammar used to be all fine. Because you need grammar, that's meaning. And you need glamour, little attraction. Glamour is not height, weight, coat, boots, suit, hat. Glamour is of your merit. See the glamour. What is this age of Amma? And still there is glamour because of the speciality and sadhana of the art in a particular area. That is called as glamour. And then humor is part of life, otherwise it will be boring. Even if it is roaring also it will be boring. So there has to be humor. then only people really can enjoy. The India has a great tradition of music from ancient period to the recent present times. The Indian classical music and arts represent India's cultural glory. Our art and dance forms act as bridge between the value system of ancient India and the new generation. They represent the eternal and everlasting principles of life and promote discipline, obedience, and peaceful coexistence. In India, various facets of performing arts bring color and joy to numerous festivals and ceremonies and reaffirm the faith of the people in their heritage. Art is not seen as a mere ornamentation or entertainment, but as an intrinsic part of our heritage. Our forefathers, our elders have created all these festivals, functions, in order to make our younger generation, our children, to know about the value and the message behind these arts. I am particularly happy and I would like to salute the Chennaites for keeping this tradition alive. You come to Chennai in December, irrespective of all the advancement, IT, all these things, but still people preserve that beauty by doing their duty, at least loving the music. If not, everybody cannot perform music. Even I can't perform music. But if at least loving the music, encouraging the music, that is also the need of the hour. I found plenty of support and love for music among the Chennaiites. I have some of the friends here. They will always be busy in the month of December, going from one Gana Sabha to other Gana Sabha, attending programs, number of programs. Life of Sri Tyagaraja Swami, a great exponent of Karnataka music, is a testimony to how music combined with devotion is the best medium to achieve God's realization. Tyagaraja, Telugu, living in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka music, three in one, what a greatness. Through his compositions, Tyaga Brahma revealed his deep understanding of the tenets of the Vedas and Upanishads, thereby providing a divine feeling to music listeners. Music in any form acts as an equalizer. It has no barriers or boundaries. It speaks universal language. It possesses the attributes that heal the mind, body and soul to make human being a liberated soul. Research found that listening to music activates not only the auditory areas of the brain, but also employs large-scale neural networks. Like music, dance in India also has an unbroken tradition of over 2,000 years. Its themes are derived from mythology, legends, and classical literature. Classical dance forms are based on ancient dance discipline and have rigid rules of presentation. There are 8 classical dance traditions, I've told: Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, Mohiniyattam, Kathak, Manipuri, Kuchipudi, Odissi, and Chahu. Bharatanatyam, though it derives its roots from Tamil Nadu, has developed into all India form. The theatre in India is as old as music and dance. Over the years, theatre has transformed the form and content in accordance with the times. Over the years, theatre has played a key role in influencing public opinion on contemporary issues. The classical theatre survives only in some places, but folk theatres can be seen in its original variants practically in every state. All such forms of Indian art and music form part of our rich culture and play a key role in unifying the country and its people. Music, dance, art, literature, it unifies the people. It has got such a magnificent power to influence the mind. Sangeetamu Pashana Naina Karigistundani. Pashanudu Manasuna Voda Karigistundani. That is the beauty of the music. But only thing is, the music has to be performed with a devotion. Then only you will get promotion and create emotion among the people. It will also relieve you from tension so that you can pay attention to your work. Because if there is a tension, you cannot have attention. My dear sisters and brothers, this rich tradition of Indian music and art must be understood in the context of Indian life and thought that promotes the concepts of harmony and integration. In the Indian worldview, art is an integral and important part of human existence and adds value to the quality of human lives. Music and dance give a mystical experience to those who perform, also to those who embrace it. Similar to yoga, music also has therapeutic powers. Music heals. It soothes and calms. Music enthralls. Music transforms our lives. Music unites and builds bridges across communities and countries. It is a unifying factor. It has to be promoted. Over the centuries, India has embraced the best form of the rest of the world, and thus our culture is a composite mixture of varying styles and influences. I am happy to learn December Art Festival is going to host around 200 artists from various music forms, from Hindustani to Harikatha to Nama Sankirtana, besides classical Carnatic. World is going through an unprecedented change. We need to honestly acknowledge that happiness quotient is dipping day by day. Our busy lifestyles are robbing us from enjoying simple aspects of life. In the present day, the fast-paced lifestyle, listening to music can provide solace to mind. Every morning when I get up, what I do is to hear Annamacharya Kirtana for at least 15 to 20 minutes. Even while I am traveling also, I best utilize that time hearing this music. I am not, I have adequate knowledge in music, but I have better understanding of the music. That's why I am able to enjoy it also. Sangeetamu, Sahityamu. Ivu rendu kuda manishiki swantaranu kaligistayi. Swantaranu kaligistayi. Ivu rendu kuda manasuku ullasanni, anandanni, utsahanni kaligistayi. Antakante kavalsindi mari emiti? Kachuto gudukunna pani kaadu. నువ్వు ఖర్చు చేయవలసిందంతా కాస్త సమయాన్నే. పనికి మాలిన పనులతో బిజీగా ఉండేదానికన్నా ఈ పనికొచ్చేయంటే చక్కని మంచి కార్యక్రమంలో పాల్గొని మానసికమైన ఉల్లాసాన్ని, సంతోషాన్ని, స్వాంతరను. నువ్వు కష్టాల్లో, నష్టాల్లో, బాధల్లో, ఇబ్బందుల్లో ఉంటే సంగీతాన్ని వింటే నీకు స్వాంతన కలుగుతుంది. ఇఫ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్, ఇఫ్ యూ స్పెండ్ టైమ్ ఇన్ మ్యూజిక్, ఇఫ్ యూ లిసన్ ద మ్యూజిక్, యూ విల్ గెట్ ద సొలేస్ యూ రిక్వైర్. వాట్ యూ కాల్ ఎస్ స్వాంతన్. The listening to music can provide solace to mind. The vast treasure of Indian musical forms need to be nurtured and propagated. Governments, art lovers, and societies as a whole must collectively encourage the musical forms to thrive and flourish. I would urge the Brahma Gana Sabha should encourage more and more younger artists to express their talent. It is incumbent on all music gurus, researchers, and connoisseurs to promote excellence in music. Time and again, studies have shown that children who are engaged in music and other art forms tend to have better cognitive skills and do well in academic subjects such as maths and science. They improve memory, auditory skills, and the attention span also. What is rise in digital technology? With this, the human attention span has shortened from 12 seconds to 8 seconds in more than a decade. A recent study by Microsoft Corporation has found humans now have an attention span of less than that of a goldfish, 9 seconds average. The 54-page study sought to understand what impact technology and today's digital lives are having on attention spans. Music learning can be made part of curriculum for school children to ensure stress-free environment and to improve learning outcomes. We are already using technology to spread this knowledge, and more students in India and abroad are learning Indian classical music through online resources and tutors. These efforts need to be further expanded. I am happy to know that NRI has come to witness the December Art Festival. Indian diaspora carries out cultural ethos, traditions to further lands. In a way, these kinds of festivals promote cultural tourism in India. Wherever our Indian Prime Minister is going, even in the recent part, I start going to different countries as a representative of India. There, the governments of the day, there, They are all welcoming us with Indian art, with music. That is the change that has come, because they now, the moment they see the Indian leader, they remind of promoting Indian art. That's why after the Prime Minister Narendra Bhai Modi has suggested introduction of yoga, 192 countries have agreed. Now yoga has become universal. It was universal, but now it is becoming universal again. Some time back, my dear friends, brothers and sisters, I have been to Latin America 3 months back, to Guatemala, to Peru, and to Panama. To my surprise and present happiness, I found at number of places yoga centers. Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji's, Baba Ramdev's. So that's the change that has come, globe, because Indian culture, Indian art, which is times immemorial, our culture and tradition and heritage, they are very, very appealing. If we are able to project it properly, propagate it properly, encourage it properly, and not to combine that with a particular religion, religion is a way of worship, but culture is a way of life. This is a tradition of India. So this music, this dance, this art, this literature, they convey the correct sense of Indian culture. You call it Indian culture, some people have a problem. You call it as Bharatiya Sanskriti, or you call it as Hindu Sanskriti. Some people have allergy and headache for Hindu. I can't give them any tablets. I can give them music tablets. If they hear that, they will understand. See, this country is known as Hindustan. I don't know why people fail, hesitate. Ye to Hindustan hai, wo Pakistan hai. This name is not, the name is not given by this party or that party. That is not linked that. This is a land, Bharatavarsha, Hindustan, which has been known for years together. We should not feel shy of our tradition, our culture, our heritage. We should feel proud that our culture, our heritage, it is times immemorial. I was just telling in the other Mahavir Foundation meeting that India was known as Vishwa Guru in all its sense. Students from the world, they used to come here and study, learn from our gurus, our sages, our rishis, and in our institutions. This was confirmed even by historians like Pahian, Yuan Song and all from China. They came and they wrote about our great Indian culture. Ours is a culture of times immemorial. And whatever our elders, our forefathers have given us, conveyed to us, there is a sense, there is a science, there is a message in everything. Right from Tulasi in front of the house or the backyard of the house to every tradition, there is some message, scientific message also. Scientific message also. We have to understand that and promote it. This is not part of a religion. This is part of promotion of our culture and heritage, which we should feel proud. Our dress, our language, our approach, our way of living is something unique, and we should feel proud of it. Some people asked me, sir, after becoming vice president, they asked me, sir, now you have become vice president. I said, okay, so what? Sir, vice president. I said, sir, batao, kya, what is next? Sir, vice president means suit, boot, band gala. So, change of dress. I said, no change of dress, only change of address only. Earlier in 30 Abdul Kalam Road. Now I have shifted to 6 Maulana Azad Road. That's the only difference. The same dress. Your respect is not going to diminish because of your dress. On the other hand, it will enhance. I must tell you, I was there the other day in the meeting of heads of states for the Paris Peace Conference. Of course, the weather was not good, but in one of the meetings, I was alone with this dress. And all the people could, they were focusing on me because of, I am something different from them. This respect will not come by wearing a suit, boot, hat. By your culture, your way of behavior, your commitment, your knowledge, your understanding, that commands your respect. So we Indians, we should, that's why I feel very happy when I come to this part of the country, southern part and particularly Tamil Nadu, the way we celebrate Pongal, the way we celebrate all the other festivals, it is something unique. Tamilian people, they are preserving the culture, traditions. Whatever good traditions. These traditions has to be preserved. They has to be respected. And you have to understand the background of these traditions or cultures. Instead of going to discussion, saying and which is rational, which is irrational and all, okay. Academic discussions are okay, no problem also. This culture, this tradition is times immemorial and we have to preserve it. Unfortunately, what is happening, earlier our leaders, our great leaders, freedom movement, right from Mahatma Gandhi to Rajagopalachari, to all great people, they used to quote from Ramayana, they used to quote from Mahabharata, they used to quote from Bhagavatam, they used to quote from Upanishads, even the Tirukkural, all these things, they're treasure of knowledge. But unfortunately nowadays, people, they try to, they feel shy. One, they have not read it. That's one thing I can understand. Second is, they feel that you talk, the moment you talk Ramayana, it is communal. What is communal in Ramayana? I am not able to understand what is communal in this. This is all political way of looking at things and all. We should feel proud, as I told you, of the way of life our forefathers have given to us. And we should preserve it. The cinema, the Rajas and Maharajas, and those days, in the elder generation, they used to promote all these arts as part of the social life. It is the duty of the village head to organize such social functions, that literary functions, musical functions. And also it used to be the duty of the pramukh, of the area. Next, it became the duty of Krishna Devaraya. You might have heard about him. All the Rajas and Maharajas, the Pallavan kings went to abroad and then constructed their temples. They are preserving their temples, our temples there. But whereas we are not bothered. This is the decline that has come. And with this, the values also are going down. The tradition, cinema. Cinema is a powerful communication. Drama, cinema is a very powerful communication. Slowly, drama is getting relegated to background. And cinema is getting more prominence. I have no problem. I have no quarrel with cinema people. But the cinema, once you go to cinema, you used to come back with some message. You used to feel happy. And then you used to enjoy with family. Can you go with family, including the director who produced the films today? Let them honestly search their souls. There are some good films, no doubt about it. But the others, Sangeetamu Sahityamu, Yanta Madhurya Nichevo, Ippudu Sangeetam Tagipoyindi, Sahityam Tagipoyindi, Vaidyam Ekkuvaipoyindi. Earlier there used to be voice, and now it is more noise in the cinema. Obscenity, vulgarity, violence, unfortunately, are dominating most of the cinemas, which is no good, and which is not welcome. This has to be understood by all people. And some people say, sir, if you don't do it, then cinema will not run for many days. Who told you? There are many beautiful films with a village background, with agriculture background, with simple background. Recently I tweeted about a Tamil cinema about the village. Oh, people started saying, Vice President is tweeting about a movie. I said, good, go and see the cinema. If you go to cinema and then come back with family, happily, enjoying and all. You go to cinema and then you can't see the face of your daughter sitting next to you. You can't look at your wife. And you can't take your mother. Then. So this is a very serious thing. The people in the cinema field, they have to pay enough attention with regard to dialogues. There are beautiful words in Tamil. There are beautiful words in other languages too. Those words can be used, but double meaning words. As I told you, if it is double meaning alone, we can understand. We want to understand, they will understand. But if you have, as I told you, obscenity, vulgarity, then the entire society is getting affected. That's why we are seeing the decline in the societal behavior also. So keeping that in mind, again, as I told you, this culture and music has to really keep up our cultural ethos. Wherever I go, I've been seeing our Indian diaspora. They are more Indian, more Bharatiya than us abroad, wherever they go. They perform Bharatanatyam, they encourage Kathakali, they wear traditional dress. they wear traditional dress and they really appeal to you. Sometime back, Narendra Bhai Modi, Prime Minister, went to London. At that time, Cameron was Prime Minister. His wife, Samantha, not present day cinema Samantha, wife Samantha, she came to public function in a sari because they know the respect it carries. So that's a tradition. And we are now feeling shy to wear a sari or put a tilak. I am not saying it's mandatory that everybody should put tilak at all. Or decent dress, as I told you, good manners, respecting the elders. What is good manners? That means some agenda is being set up. What is the agenda? Respecting the elders, is it wrong? Respecting parents, is it wrong? Respecting fellow human beings, is it wrong? Respecting nature, is it wrong? So love and live with the nature. So nature, culture, together for better future. We started neglecting nature. And we are seeing the disaster. The nature, we have played with the nature, even Chennai, earlier floods also. Part of it is man-made. Even others, whatever is happening also. We played with the nature. We did not preserve the nature. We have to go back. And secondly, with regard to lifestyle also. The sedentary lifestyle is adding to social tension and decline in the quality of life. We have to educate our children. And life is becoming mechanical. Mechanical. I am not asking everybody to become philosophical at this age. But why should you become mechanical? If you understand our tradition, our culture, our heritage, you will be able to get proper guidance. And I feel dance, music, art, literature, they are the best forms to communicate our ancient culture and heritage to people in a better manner rather than a speech by persons. Indian music was enriched by contributions of many great musical exponents, Tyagaraja Swami, Shyama Shastri, Bharataratna M.S. Subbulakshmiji and Pandit Bhimsen Joshi, D.K. Pattammal and Mangalampalli Balamurali Krishna, to name a few great masters. Friends, brothers and sisters, I had an opportunity. I am from Nellore, nearby. During my school days, this S.P. Balasubramaniam, he is from our place. His father, Sri Panditaradula Samamurthy, he used to go around all streets and sing Hari Sankirtana in the morning and used to collect rice, and that plural rice he used to organize Tyagaraja festival. Now you feel shy to come out and sing in streets. And then those days, continuous festivals are going on. Well, before going to school, our area, there used to be a town hall. And I remember two people, those two names have registered in my mind. One is Chambai Vaidyanath Iyer, I think I am right, is that name. Second is D.K. Pattammal. Both of them, I had an occasion to see them and hear them during that younger age. After hearing them, I developed some interest. And I found some rasa in what they are offering to the people. My dear friends, if we must also bring our children to programs so that they also get inspiration. And they have proper respiration. If you are, in many ways, Indian musicians have given the world a rare menu of soul-stirring musical masterpieces. I am glad that this ancient tradition is being continued without a break. However, I am aware of the innovations being tried out within this tradition. The electronic era has brought new dimensions to music concerts. We must preserve the best traditions. We must what we have inherited and add further richness with our creative genius. Brahma, the first god in the Hindu trinity, signifies creativity, innovation. He is also a vast reservoir of knowledge. Musicians who have achieved excellence have combined these two qualities. They have excellent knowledge of musicology, but they think of improvising and bringing new and creative ways to enrich the tradition through their rendition of classical songs. We all draw inspiration from the Narada Brahma and many other Nada Brahmas, including the illustrious Tyaga Brahma. We have enriched the world of music and left a deep impression on our inner consciousness. Thanks to technology, we can listen to these compositions anytime, anywhere, and any number of times. Thanks to technology, we have a unique opportunity to reach to much wider audience than ever before. We must use all these new avenues, in addition to the concerts we hold regularly, for preserving and propagating the richness of Indian music. I once again congratulate the organizers for holding this festival and contributing to this noble mission. This is a mission not for any commission. Just to make the society feel happy. So such missions has to be encouraged, and I feel really happy that I've been able to come here and participate in this program, and I've been able to compliment, congratulate, and felicitate these great souls. Felicitation by felicitating these people. They are not going to get anything additional. Felicitation is to give inspiration to others, the new generation. That is the purpose of this felicitation program. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Nandri. Vanakkam.